It's a 2,300-mile race from Los Angeles to Honolulu. It's one of the premier ocean racing events in the world.
It's extremely difficult to get into, but Roy Disney...
Charlie.
Well, Peter told all of us to leave all of our follies at home. We could leave, you know, bring out our warm stuff. As you can see, we're dressed to go to the Aleutians.
I thought we were going to the Aleutians.
But the tropics.
Hawaii? I thought Hawaii was downwind.
Yeah.
Peter says we're going to Alaska right now.
We've been going upwind the whole way. It's stormy seas and clouds. But everybody's getting along great. We're having a great time, and we're just busting ass, and we're going to win this thing.
Day one, it's not working out at all as we planned. But Horizon's right there, and we're going to get them.
Well,
there you go.
In the water?
And Bill?
Laundry report, Bill. Continue the...
It's not that exciting. It's only day one, shirt one. So... here it is.
But no one's puking yet.
That's a good.
That
good
is segment. Way ahead of expectations.
Alrighty, your turn then.
All right, I'll start with Hans here. He's an asshole. I really just hate his guts. Just can't do anything right. Can't drive. Can't trim. Can't cook. Can't talk. There you go. Then there's this guy, Charlie. Yeah, that's Charlie. He's working really hard, but he doesn't know what to do. He's an asshole. Then Big Mike. We should never have invited him on. Basically an asshole. And then there's you. You're the biggest asshole of all. That's Chris.
Both full of assholes.
They're basically a bunch of assholes. And I hate this. I never want to do this again. I don't know why a couple of these trips. An asshole said in the cockpit. That's right. So, no, I'm hating life right now. I hate it.
Magic, Mike!
We only get to Hawaii. We'll see how much magic I got. Hey, Chris, how you doing?
Pretty good. How you, man?
I'm having a great time. I've never been out here before. I mean, once a delivery, never doing the race. This is fantastic. I mean, what's not to love? You got a great group of guys. Beginning at the very top of the heap with Bill, who draws
good. He's trying to pick us up.
draws good people to the program. Don't ignore them. You got blue water, you got blue skies, you got good food. It's just fantastic out here.
Really?
It's fantastic out here.
Jasper thought you were, he was sailing a with a bunch of assholes.
No. Upwind, no. Both ways.
I don't think
I got a rash on my ass so bad.
But still, I can't complain.
Can't complain.
Well, the status report is we moved up a notch in yesterday's position. We slowed. We got a setback on the second day of the race, and we're climbing back from that. So we've gained corrected time hours on most of our competitors, and we're on the course that we want to sail. We think it's a good course. So we're still in this race, and we're still climbing the ladder and doing well. We're going to get there. We got a good crew. We got a great navigator. We're working hard now.
What's happening here? Now, why is it that we're heading due south?
Well, it seems that we are sailed into the Pacific High, or the Pacific High sailed over us, and we're trying to escape to the south and see if we can find more breeze.
Hey, tell us about that party. Didn't you sponsor the Transpac It Up party, you and Erica?
Yeah, that was more Erica than me. That was something Erica wanted to do, and I totally supported it. It was a great party. Too bad more of the Deceptionites didn't show up.
Well, it is too bad they didn't show up. But, you know, I think maybe that's why you're along on the Transpac here, is you've got that wonderful girlfriend, Erica. We look forward to seeing her in Hawaii.
Yeah, she's going to be there before me. She leaves tomorrow morning, and I'm excited to see her. Another reason to sail fast.
How many emails are you sending her a day?
Oh, just the one or two.
Just one or two,
yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
I think that's why our batteries are so far down. You're sending her too many emails.
I don't think that's the case. I think it's. I just figured out how to use the thing.
All right. Who's your bunkmate here on the Deception?
I'm sleeping with the captain here.
Yeah, well, that's the way to get ahead.
Yeah.
Day six. We're about halfway through the cookies.
Thank you, Sue.
No, I think we're down to about 20 pounds of cookies.
All right, we have the halfway note that Alice sent along to us. So, we'll read it. It's for Boo and each of you. Boo being me or Tarpy, depending on the context.
I hope she's talking about you.
I think she is in this one. The God of the Sea doesn't need you. I know, because I need you more. The God of the Sea has a deal with me to bring your boat safely to shore. The God of the Sea saw you coming and smiled as he cast out the sea, for he knows that I keep all my bargains, and he notes that he made one with me. And if some night your sky should be moonless, or the sun, or the clouds you can't see, you'll know that I traded the moon and the sun for you all with the God of the Sea. Thank you, Alice.
Hey. Oh,
you're here.
Very nice.
That is.
My wife just smuggles booze on the boat.
That works.
That works.
Hey, Robin.
That works. Little
the halfway drink. Hi, guys. Hi, Mary. Having a great time. Got a great crew. We're halfway there. Unfortunately, the wind is also halfway there.
Did we run out of condoms yet? they have a whole spiel about the red hats being like for elite sailors only. We don't sell them anywhere but at races. At which point Robbie goes, I've got 30 of them.
Well, we can get another one, yeah.
Probably.
And they all went, wow.
Hey, hi. Hi, Chris. Hi, everybody.
It's a huge deal.
The sun is out. A tremendous group of guys.
It's amazing what men will do to men.
Ladies, take note.
You don't like it whenever I get maudlin. You don't like it, do you? You always got to jump in there with something. I was going to say that the really important things we have here, all present.
Everything we really need.
That's
everything
good.
Everything we really need.
Because if one of us wasn't present, it'd be a bad deal.
Yep. That's right. This is the Magnificent Eight.
Lord of the Rings.
I mean, what's going on?
The opinion is we're going to try to save our asses through this squall. That's what we're trying to do. But we're back on course. Boat speed over 11.
Ahead of me.
Yeah, you brought it into 24 knots a minute ago. Well, thank God we're in the tropics. The long underwear has gone away. And we're sailing in shorts. This shirt has got to get some use now as opposed to sitting in the bag. In fact, it might get its first wash because I can feel the raindrops coming right now from the squall.
Yep.
Another night in the tropics, a tropical paradise.
I don't know what those guys are doing.
I'm about to start a 4-hour check.
Take it off!
About being different leads.
Into the day. The moon is up, so if we have some clear skies, we can at least see where we're going, which is right at the moon. And we're still making hay towards Hawaii. Hot showers, Mai Tais, toilet paper. Oh, and did I mention somebody forgot to tri-fold the toilet paper, so we have a big brown smudge right in the middle of the bucket?
Those shitters shitted
up the shit bucket. So we have a whole
but now that's in the log.
Well, we're gonna place this camera where it needs to be so we can find out who the...
I thought that was the GoPro. It's already there.
Oh really?
To document it.
Well, it wasn't me.
Very good.
Your opinion of the net so far?
Well, this is the third crossing on Deception.
many decisions. Got it. Nice. A little less windy this year than years past. Doesn't look like we're going to have the full-on trades. So we're working hard to get the boat moving. It's been actually a fairly uneventful crossing, no major drama. It's sort of hot, though. Hotter than usual.
Or at least, food?
The food has been extraordinary. Peter did a great job with that. We're looking at a little longer trip than anticipated, so we stretched out one of the meals the extra day. The pulled pork sandwiches, along with the carrot. So I kind of turned from one dinner into two because we were overserved on both days. I had the halfway party yesterday, I think. Let's see. It is nice to sail with the hatch open, get some air in the boat. For this trip, more than any other trip, we really missed the code zero for that first day or two.
Far out. They're having a good time.
Yeah. No, it's a pleasant trip with friends.
What are we doing here?
You're going to give me the status report.
Oh, the status report? I don't have it up. I can't give you the whole status report.
You just read it.
Huh? That's Peter's job.
Thank you.
That's Peter's job.
I think we'll have enough food to make it. Fell back to fifth. It's going to be hard making it up. But I think we can get third. That's the short end of the stick. We're going to end up rowing ourselves all the way to Hawaii. Nah, I think yesterday Horizon found a nice little band of breeze. They were 60 miles away, and we were skunked in 6 knots of shit.
Come on.